And so now let's go look at the application. So for this, we're going to go to the branch lists, and we're going to go into the corporate branch here. And now that we're inside the branch profile, your branch links are going to be located under the web form integration tab. So web form integration. And up here at the top is the full loan app and all the links for the full loan app. But I like to start at the quick app level. So we're going to minimize this full loan app section by clicking anywhere on this gray bar. And we're going to minimize that. And now it's showing us the quick app section. So now looking at the quick app section, this first blue link that we see here, the one that says real estate URL link, that's the clickable URL link for the quick app. So we're going to click on that and it'll open up the quick app in a new browser tab right here. We're looking at our application here. So this application you're seeing, there's no fields, there's no questions yet, because this is all built around conditional logic based off of the loan programs. So we're going to answer these no right here, but then we are presented with the question of which loan program are you looking for? So now we're going to select the drop down here. And once we select, let's say, fix and flip, now all the questions and all the fields for a fix and flip loan program kick in, right? So now we're looking, we see borrower info sections, borrower type, borrower experience, SBA questions, assets. Then we get down to the schedule of real estate owned and sold. And I'm going to go down to the loan term section right here. So now when you initially are looking at your application for the first time and you come into the transaction type dropdown, you might see a lot of options that maybe you don't want to see on a fix and flip application, right? So what we're seeing now is or a lot of options, and we probably want to clean this up if we were going to actually have the fix and flip options listed there. So, you know, you have somebody select a fix and flip loan program. Maybe you wouldn't want them to see all these or be able to select from any of these. So, same thing for loan terms. If you come in here and select loan terms on a fix and flip, you wouldn't want somebody to be able to select any or all of these options on a fix and flip. So, we're going to clean that up and change those options. Same thing when we go down to the subject property details right here. So if we go to the subject property type and we look at the drop down for subject property type, we can scroll through this list and see that there are a lot of different subject property types to choose from. And we wouldn't want somebody that's filling out a fix and flip application to be able to choose any and all of these either. So we're going to clean these options up and just put a few options in there. So to do this, we're going to keep this tab open. We're going to keep this application tab open, and we're going to go into the back office, and we're going to go down to the settings, platform settings, and we're going to go to the custom loan guidelines right here. So when we're looking at the settings and the platform settings, we see all these options over here on the left-hand side menu. Those options are very similar to the options that you see up here at the top. They're not exactly the same. They're very similar, but you're going to be able to access these things from two different places, just two different places to access the same thing. Okay. So we're in the custom loan guidelines right now. So if you don't have any custom loan guidelines, let's say for your fix and flip, then you would just go in and create a new one. But we already have one, so we're just going to open up this one and we're going to click on the edit button for the fix and flip. And so when you're going to create one, you're just going to go to add new. You're going to select no right here. And then you're going to select your loan program from this dropdown. And then you'll be able to start filling this in based on your guidelines for that loan program. We already have a fix and flip here, so we're just going to edit this one. So we're going to edit right here. And you can see it says no for edit marketplace known right there. It says no. And we have the correct module, which we're currently in the commercial residential real estate module. And you can see that the loan program already has the fix and flip selected there. So now, if we wanted to change the transaction type to not show all of the options, it's currently showing all of the options. We can come in here and just say, okay, maybe we just want to show purchase, rate and term refinance, and cash out refinance, right? Or maybe we just want to put purchase and refinance. All right. And for the property type, it's currently showing all of these available, right? But we're going to change that. We're just going to put single family home. We'll put 2 to 4 units. Well, maybe we'll put condo, townhouse, and we'll put 2 to 4 units, and we'll put multifamily 5+, and we'll leave it there. And then for the loan terms that we saw, we saw that long list of loan terms available, but maybe we just want to put 12 months, 18 months, let's say 24 months. All right. And now we can click save. All right, so we've got the confirmation there that we saved our custom loan guidelines, right? So now I can go back into the application here and I can refresh this page. All right, so now I'm going to answer no on these. I'm going to select my fix and flip loan program. I'm going to go back down to the loan terms section. So now I'm looking at the loan terms. And when I look at the transaction type dropdown now, if I click on that, now I'm only seeing purchase and refinance. Now I'm not seeing that long list of all the different transaction types. I just have the ones that I want for my fix and flip. Same thing with the loan terms. If I click on that dropdown, now I'm only seeing 12 months, 18 months, and 24 months, right? So now it's more and more relevant. And when I go down to the subject property type, same thing. If I click on that dropdown, I'm going to see only single family home, condo, townhouse, 2 to 4 units, and multifamily 5+. So that's how we make the application relevant to your actual loan program. So you're not getting options that show up out of left field that have nothing to do what's to what's available through your loan program. So same thing, let's say somebody's filling out some of these other options like subject property state. Somebody might want to limit the options that are shown as a subject property state. So when you're editing the custom loan guidelines and the application, the options that are shown in the application, it's always helpful to have it set up this way, right? Where you have one tab with the application itself and then another tab with your back office. So you can go back and forth and make changes as you need them. So let's say we wanted to limit the subject property state dropdown to just a few states. We can go back into our custom loan guidelines. I can click on this dropdown right here, click on the edit button. And it'll open back up right here. So now, if I wanted to go in and select different states, I can just select them from here. Right? Let's say I just wanted to select Florida and Texas. All right, I can hit the save button now. Get the confirmation that my changes have been made, and now I can go back into my quick app. I can refresh this. I'll say no on these questions, select the fix and flip again, and then I can go down into the subject property section. And if I click on this subject state now it's only showing California, Florida, and Texas. All right, so that's how you start making changes to what's available in your drop-down options on your application. And if I wanted to change that, Maybe I just wanted to allow all states. I can just click on select all and give it a few seconds and all will show up as well. All right. Then when you're finished, just click that save button and look for that confirmation that your changes have been updated.